Welcome to All Nations Church. We restore and release potential in people by connecting them to God.
Welcome, welcome, All Nations Church, a place to come discover. Here at All Nations Church, we release potential in people by connecting them to God. Last week, Influence Conference 2023 was an amazing time. Thank you so much, Wise Builders, for putting it together for us. Friday Gala, the women looked stunning. Saturday Worship Night, thank you so much, Minister Dinah Hamilton, for taking us into a time of worship. Sunday with Pastor Jana Alcorn. Man, staying in your story. One thing that stuck with me was one chapter doesn't make a book. This week alone, our very own Bishop Frank Ofosu-Appiah, the Ambassador of Hope, took us in Minding the Gap. Make sure you tune in every Tuesday at 6 p.m. EST prompt. Are you ready? Are you excited? Are you excited to hear the Word of God today? Before we get into the Word, grab your phones, grab your screens, your tools, your apparatus, anything that you're using to worship with us today, and share it. Share it to a friend. Share it to a family, to your loved ones, your enemy. Like our mama always says, if it's worth hearing, it is worth sharing. Our word today is by our very own bishop, titled The Blessing. But before we get into the word, let's welcome the very own, the in-house, the whole we are seeing, Kharis Worship.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Good morning, All Nations Church. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Has God been good to you? Come on and stand on your feet. The key to entering into the presence of the Lord is a thank you. So I want you to take the next 10 seconds and just say thank you. Just remember how far God has brought you and just say thank you. I'm grateful to you, Father, for life, for the gift of life, for the gift of health, for the gift of strength. I'm grateful to you that you put food on my table. I'm grateful to you, Lord, that you put clothes on my back. You have put a roof over my head. Come on and open your mouth, and from the depths of your heart, release gratitude to God. Say thank you to Him. You may not have all that you want, but trust me, you are not where you used to be. We thank you, God. See how far you brought me. I'm so glad you found me worthy. I can see, I can tell, and I know it's your grace. All my days I will sing your praise. Sing Ezebube, see how far you brought me. I can see, I can tell, and I know your grace. All my days I will sing. Tell, and I know it's your grace. All my days I will sing your praise. Sing, yes, yes, see how far you brought me. Sing, yes, I'm so glad you found me. I can see, I can tell, and I know. Your grace, all my days I will see. I can see, sing, I can see, I can tell, and I know it's your grace. All my days I will sing your praise. Sing, I can see, I can tell, and I know it's your grace. Jesus, all my days I will sing your praise. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We serve an amazing God. We serve a God who loves us with an unconditional love. Turn to your neighbor and tell them God loves you. Turn to the next person, tell them God loves you. Now turn to somebody else and welcome them into the house of the Lord. And now with a clap offering, can we welcome the presence of the Lord in the sanctuary this morning? God has been good. Hallelujah. Woo! God is good. God is good. Come on.
Too much, oh, excess love, oh.
Stand here today, and I know that I have everlasting life. You are the King of kings. You are the Lord of lords. You are the mighty God, and there is none like you. Creator of the heavens and the earth, we exalt your holy name, mighty God. We lift you up, O God, above all else, my God. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor, O God. Ancient of days, be thou exalted, my God. You stand in a class all by yourself, and you are the one that we exalt. You are the one that we worship. You are the one that we come and we bow our knee to. Lily of the valley, the bright and morning star. We have come to pour our worship, my God, at your feet. For you alone are deserving of all the worship. You alone are deserving of all the praise, oh God. Take all the glory, my God. Take all the honor, my God. Be thou exalted. Yeah. voice and sing. We give, we give.
Nobody else like you, Lord. Oh,
the ruler of everything. Oh, glorified in this place, oh God. Hallelujah. Be glory. Did you come with a worship? Did you come with worship? Come on, this is a good place to release it. Tell the Lord, be glorified. Tell the Lord, be exalted. Tell the Lord, be magnified. Tell the Lord, be exalted. Come on, open your mouth, somebody. Magnify the name of the living God. He alone is worthy. He alone is worthy. Worthy to receive all glory. Worthy to receive all honor. Magnify the name of the Lord, somebody. Somebody magnify his name. He alone is worthy. He said a dependable God. I don't know about you, but when your back is against the wall, he's the one who is there for you. When everybody else has left, he is the one who is there for you. He's a faithful God. Faithful God. Hallelujah. Dependable, dependable God. It doesn't matter what comes my way, you are still God. Intentional, intentional God. Everything is working out for my good.
Dependable.
from the wisdom of God's heart. The commission has gone forth. Through the pursuit and the knowledge of God, we position ourselves to encounter and utilize the presence and power of God to do great things in the world. It is the day to empower God's people to walk in dominion of all aspects of life and leadership. It is the season to engage the nations for the cause of the King and His kingdom. It is the season for new challenges, new achievements, and new levels of productivity. These are the days of His power. These are the days of His grace. These are the days of His majesty. 2023, our year of exploits. Please stand and welcome our senior pastor, Dr. Frank Ofosu-Appiah.
Bless the Lord in the house. Amen. You want to turn around to your left, to your right, welcome somebody to church this morning. Let them know that we're excited. We're a community. We're a family. Bless the Lord. I think the people to my left are not obeying me at all. The balcony too, I don't see movement. People don't bite, you know, just say hello to somebody. Let them know you're excited to see them. It may even be an opportunity for some man to propose. Let's do that. You never know. You may be seated. And thank you, Kharis Worship. God bless you so much for helping us worship the Lord easier and better. Good morning again. Remember, we are live on all our handles. We are live on Facebook. We are live on YouTube, Twitter, formerly called Twitter, and IG. We bless God for your lives. Amen. Have you had a good week? We thank the Lord for all of you, for all the pastors and everybody. God richly bless you. Amen and amen and amen. We really appreciate you, all the men and women that have heeded and accepted the call of God upon your life. It is not an easy walk. You could have been doing other things. There's something called divine interruptions. Most of the men and women that God called, He interrupted their lives. You can always tell from Abraham, Moses, all of them, their lives were interrupted. Simon, Peter, everybody. There's a divine interruption that comes into our lives where God steps in. And sometimes there's no clarity. Sometimes it's risky. Sometimes it's scary. You have to walk that path to understand what I'm talking about. Sometimes it's unforgiving, unrelenting. Sometimes, you stood and God richly bless you. God richly bless you. We really appreciate you. Thank God for your lives. Thank God for your life. We're going to study God's word together. I think we have about 6 baby dedications. People have been very busy, you know. People have been very busy. Yeah. Very busy. Had it not been for this, how would we know that? This is the last Sunday of October, is it? Yeah. Why? Time flies. Anyway, we're going to study God's word together. You need to fasten your seatbelt. We're going to have some, you know, meat for adults. We're going to study. You know, when we come into God's house, we bring worship to our King corporately. Then we also sit together and we learn. We become better, we grow, we mature, we get discipled as we study God's word. The Bible says that as we looked into the perfect law of liberty, we are transformed into His image. You know, the Bible says that who He foreknew, He also predestined to be conformed to the image of his son, Romans 8 and 29, that he may be the firstborn amongst many brethren. So what happens is that day by day, as we come to church, as we study, we are transformed. Transformation is the end game for everything, not just having something, transaction, but transformation. And today we want to bring a word, God's word that he gave us, his guiding word he gave to all of us, you know, all our churches, organizations all over the world, comes from Daniel chapter number 11 and verse number 32. He says that for the people that know their God, that is the second part, but the people who know their God, you must know your God, not your father's God, not somebody else's God, but you must know your God. The result is that they shall be strong, and then they shall carry out great exploits. God wants you and I to carry out great exploits. When we talk about great exploits, we are talking about accomplishing mighty things, doing great things in your life. You know, doing extraordinary, you must be somebody in your house that people will always remember because you came into the family and you made a difference. Amen. Today, I want to address one of the great but often neglected catalysts that help us, because we overlook the fact that you can be nice, you can be beautiful, you can have a lot of degrees, in fact more degrees than a thermometer, you can have business acumen, you can do everything, but there's always a missing ingredient that you need upon that which you have to make it extraordinary. We are talking about exploits, but a catalyst for exploits is something that I want to address today, and it's called the blessing. Somebody say the blessing.
Yes.
Say like you mean it.
Yes.
Because it is one of the overlooked virtues and blessings that God gives to us, the blessing. I am an observer of church and of trends. I study a lot. And I realize that gradually, the modern day church, we are losing something that God gave to us for our benefit. A lot of people are struggling unnecessarily because in our own intellect, we have shifted away from the things that can make life a little bit easy for us. When I consider why a man could come to a father and cry in agony and say, even though my brother has taken the blessing, which was supposed to be mine, don't you even have one? Just one to give to me. I studied that thing and I realized that the patriarchs of old understood something that this generation we are missing. It's called a blessing. And I'll try a little bit to define a blessing, because sometimes some things are very hard to define. But when I say a blessing, this is what I wrote down. I said it's a spoken declaration. A blessing is a spoken declaration by an authority over an individual. It could be a spiritual authority. It could be a parental authority. But it's an authority. So for those who disrespect your parents, they may not be as anointed as you are or educated, but God has placed some things in their lives. Where I stand today, anytime I go back to my roots and I go to my mom and I spend time with her before I leave, I tell her, Mom, bless me, speak. Just speak. For somebody who has lived this earth for 90 years, speak. Just say something. Just the voice. And we are missing this thing. And I said, it's a spoken declaration, spoken by an authority over an individual. And when that thing happens, it empowers you to succeed, even under unfavorable conditions. Which means when you carry a blessing on your life, regardless of the external circumstances that you operate in, you still stand out. A woman or a man that has been blessed can never be put down. You are like a balloon or something that somebody tries to push underwater. No matter what, you still come out. And this principle of blessing is shown through the entirety of the Word of God. And like I said a little earlier, the patriarchs of old did not joke with the blessing at all. In fact, in Genesis, let's look at this thing. In Genesis, you get into Genesis chapter number 1. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth and all the creative efforts. And the Bible says, and the Lord God said, let us make man in our own image, after our own likeness. And God did that. He breathed into man became a living soul. And the first thing that God did, in a very pristine, holy, untouched environment in the garden, no Satan appeared, was that the Lord God blessed them, and he said, now, if blessed by the flesh needed the blessing when there was no devil, what makes you think you don't need a blessing when there are a lot of devils? All around, don't look anywhere, all around you. What makes you think, look, am I making sense this morning? Just think about that. The Lord God blessed them, and he said, it was a blessing in a pristine, sinless environment. Abraham, the Lord said, come out and I will bless you and I'll make you a great nation. And when Abraham obeyed, Eliezer of Damascus in Genesis 32, I guess, when he stood in the house of Nahor, he said, regarding Abraham, he said, the Lord God has blessed my master Abraham and he has made him great. And he has given him a lot of cattle, silver, gold, men, servants. There's a manifest. The blessing is not a thing, but the blessing manifests the thing. Oh, I have some things to say today. The patriarchs, they blessed. Isaac blessed. He said to Esau, let me bless you. My soul bless you. I will explain that. Jacob, before he died in Genesis 49, he called his 12 sons and he released a blessing upon them. And the last thing that Jesus did before he ascended, in the last chapter of Luke's gospel, 24, he said, and he blessed them. And after that, he was taken into heaven. He blessed them. So it's important. In Numbers chapter 6 and verse number 22, there's something that is called the priestly blessing. The priestly blessing in Numbers 6, 22. He said, and the Lord God said to Moses, saying, let's go. Speak to Aaron. Aaron and his sons represent the priesthood. Today, please don't let anything distract you. Speak to Aaron and his sons, saying, so you remember, and the Lord God blessed them, and he said. So blessings is a declaration. It's spoken over your head. Something hangs over your head. Never forget that. And he said, this is the way you shall bless. How? Say to them. Say to them. So the blessing comes with a declaration. It's something that is the oils and wells on the inside of an authority figure, but he speaks it over your head. And he says, say to them that the Lord bless you and the Lord keep you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and be merciful to you, the Lord. I mean, we know all that. This month, incidentally, is Pastor's Appreciation Month. I hope you have appreciated the pastor. I'm not talking to you. I hope you have appreciated a pastor. I hope you have appreciated a pastor. I wrote here, it's going to get rough. But I want to open your eyes and use this opportunity to help you about how to assess some blessings. And plain is through your connection with your man of God. Now, let me say something to you. I stand here with all humility before God and you that I have no personal interest in what I'm going to teach you. Because if you know me longer than a second, you know that this man, Frank Ofosu-Appiah, I do not seek the accolades of men. So I don't get disappointed when you ignore me. I don't want to be a hero in anybody's story. I don't want even my name to be in your testimony. But I stand as your Caruso, as your teacher, as your Herald, to teach you the truth that will help you. Because when you get blessed, I get happy and I sit back. So it's never about me, but I want to teach you how you can assess your blessing. And one of them is through your connection with your man of God. Deuteronomy chapter 33, that's my scripture for today, verse number 1. I'll pick up another one and we are done. Now this thing hit me like a sledgehammer. Deuteronomy chapter 33, verse number 1. Now, this is the blessing. Somebody say, this is the blessing. Is the blessing. Say it like your mouth belongs to you. It says that this is the blessing with which Moses, the man of God, blessed the children of Israel before his death. Now, I'm not going to die yet. But he says that this is the blessing. Please follow me. This is the blessing with which Moses, the man of God, blessed the children of Israel before his death. Everything that is recorded in the book is very important. You may not like it, you may not understand it, but it will bless somebody. Now, this is the first time in the entirety of God's word that the designation man of God is used. This is the first time in the Bible that we see the designation man of God. They didn't use it for Adam, didn't use it for Abraham. Or it says that this Moses, the man of God. Then after this, it appears 75 times in the Bible. In one instance, when the Shunammite woman was dealing with Elisha, 9 times he called him, oh, man of God, in one chapter. 75 times. Now, I wish I didn't have to use all these big words. In biblical hermeneutics, interpretations, there's something called the law of first mention. Anything that is mentioned for the first time in the Bible, you can use that as a precedent to explain principles. The blood of your brother is kind of first mention. Talks about blood, life. And so the first mention. So we look at it and it informs the rest. So let's interrogate what happened in this first mention. There are 3 things I'm going to pick up and I'll step out of your way. Keep the scripture there for me. Number one, we are going to look at the Bible says Moses is referred to as the man. So you can put my notes out there. Moses is referred to as the man of God. So number one, we are going to look at the man of God. Number two, Moses is blessing. So a man of God blesses. He doesn't curse. He blesses. And then number three, he blesses the people of God. So Moses, number one, is referred to as the man of God. If you are making notes, number two, he is blessing. Number three, he's blessing God's people. So let's unpack it a little bit and then we see what happens. Number one, Moses is referred to as man of God. Now please note this. Every designation there is important. Number one, he's a man. He's not referred to as God. He is human. In case somebody has forgotten, your man of God is human. Your pastor is human. For those who worship us, please quit idol worship. He is human. For those who think that men of God walk on air, they are human. For those who only see their mistakes, they are human. For those who only see their shortcomings and magnify their bad days, they are human. Thank you. They are human. But they are called. They are prepared. They are anointed. They are stretched. They go through things to be commissioned by God. Hebrews chapter 5, verse number 1. The apostle writing to us said, every high priest is a man. Every pastor is a man chosen. It's not a mass call. It's a chosen thing to represent other people in their dealings with God. Do you see that? So he is chosen amongst men what to be a representative. And he presents their gifts to God and offers sacrifices for their sins. So he is called. Give me verse number 4, please. I hope you are learning. Give me verse number 4. And it says that no one can become a high priest simply because he wants such an honor. So to those of you who you look at pastors and you think you are more eloquent, and you see their shortcomings and that gives you a call. No. He says that you cannot choose yourself such an honor. He must be called by God for his work, just as Aaron was. This thing is a calling. That is why, listen, let me tell you something. When you are genuinely called, you can't walk away. You can't. Do we feel like every day? Why? Because humanity also speaks. But divinity holds you. Paul the apostle said, he said, I lay hold for which I am laid hold of. The Latin said, eternio, eternio. I hold on to that which has held on to me. You can't. If I preach the gospel, Paul said, I have nothing to boast about, for necessity is laid upon me. Woe is me if I don't preach the gospel. And he says, if I preach it willingly, I have a reward. But if I preach it unwillingly, it's because a dispensation, a compulsion is upon me. That is what drives a called person. You don't take the honor to yourself. God does that. Then number two, Moses, the man of God, is blessing. So please hear me. I told you from the beginning, this is not vested interest message. It's to help you. Your man of God, or somebody listening to your woman of God, or your boy of God, whichever, is an agent of blessing for you. And when God calls them, he puts some tremendous things on the inside of them to be a blessing. But unfortunately, this thing has been denigrated. It has been fought against. It has been watered down. Some have even plain refused it today. People have set up pages on social media just to fight a principle that blesses you. The fact that a man of God offended you doesn't give you a ministry to fight all men of God. And the one who offended you doesn't represent me. And chances are that I have offended you, and I will offend you. It's my honor and my privilege to do that, because there's a test. Some people forget, Pastor Kwame, that just as some people go to medical school for 7 years, some of us have sat more than 7 years in Bible schools. You think we went there to sleep? And I've been through semesters where we didn't even open the Bible. They gave us case studies like you. How to pastor people like you. So we are also trained. We paid money, top dollar. For this, I don't know. Today we think kingdom order is just like democracy. We can hire our leaders and fire them any day. Because of all the things we've seen with charismatics, then Pentecostals, then Methodists, then Baptists, then congregational rule, and we are calling a pastor and we are hiring a pastor. So today we have lost kingdom order. So if we don't like him, we fire him. And then another one comes and we interview him. You don't fear? You interview him. Not so, my friend, with the economy of God. And my burden is to bring divine order and alignment for all of us. Hear me. Your man of God, your woman of God, whatever, is an instrument of your blessing. His presence in your life, he may not speak every time with you, but it's a tremendous blessing and something in your life. You go to church, he doesn't even talk, he doesn't say anything. At the end, he raises a voice. Remember, speak. And he says, God bless you. He has given you something all your monies cannot buy. Let's look at a couple of benefits. Let's look at it. Number one, they feed you. Your man of God, he feeds you. What does he feed you with? With knowledge and understanding through the delivery of the word of God. Remember some of you how your lives were? You could even save $2 for 10 years. You couldn't make good decisions. Everything that came up the freeway slept with you. Please forgive me. I have a burden. Let me speak it. Until you came in and your eyes opened. Remember how your life was? Knowledge and understanding. He said in Jeremiah chapter 3, verse 14, 15. He said, return to me by sliding nation. Come to me. Come back. And I will put you together. And he said, when I have gathered you, I'm going to do something. I will give you pastors after my own heart. Shepherds after my own heart who will feed you with knowledge and understanding. They will feed you with knowledge and understanding. That is why some things come up to you. Don't come with preconceived ideas. They feed you with knowledge and understanding. Very important. Isaiah said in Isaiah 63:6 that wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of your times. And so we feed you so that you'll be stable in the times that we are in. We feed you. Sometimes it's hard. When we were all growing up until we became adults, when we could choose what we could eat. That's an unfortunate side of life. You know, remember when you didn't have any money to buy a dining table? You could eat anything. But when you got money to buy one, now you can't eat things. But knowledge and wisdom to make you stable. So sometimes the word that we give to you may not like you. I don't like broccoli. I don't even know why anybody should like Brussels sprouts. But they're vegetables. They help. They help. So sometimes we'll give you meat, strong meat that belongs to elders. So it's not every day that you clap and jump and say, Pastor, you bless me. Sometimes the hard one must even be the blessing. Because let me tell you something. If you're in a church and your pastor cannot rebuke you, both of you are in trouble. Yeah, because he has left you to yourself. Your pastor must be able to look at you in the eye and talk to you. Today, I have my pulse on a lot of churches and pastors. Pastors are afraid because they will lose you very quickly because you have options. Or at least you stay online. So they feed you. Number two, they protect you. Hear me. This world is not a playpen. You need to have your back watched. I kid you not. You see some patterns, some systems in your family line, and you think your degree can take it away? You need your back watched. That's why they are called shepherds. They watch over the sheep. When the Bible calls you sheep, it's not a compliment. Unless you don't understand how sheep behave. How sheep behave. So we are called overseers. Overseer, we see over. Whilst you are busy grazing and eating everything, and the predators are looking for you, the overseer looks over and warns you. Acts chapter 20. Paul says something to the church at Miletus, verse 28. He said, therefore, take heed to yourselves and to all the flock, talking to the leaders, pastors, men of God, women of God. Take heed, first of all, to yourself and to all the flock, among which the Holy Spirit has made you overseers. You see that? It's God that appoints leaders in church. To do what? Shepherd the church of God, which he purchased with his blood. His own blood. So you are not my property. You are the property of Christ. But my designation is to shepherd you. This is his reason. For I know that after my departure, savage wolves will come among you. Will come among you. Yeah, they are here. Savage wolves, predators, not sparing the flock. Please listen to sometimes the reason why we are so passionate, because we know what you don't know. And I am not bound to give you a blow-by-blow report of what I know. So when I say don't, it means don't. When I speak with my eyes to you, don't throw me under the bus. I know you are going to be hurt. That is why you booked the appointment and I didn't mind you. Because I warned you from the pulpit. I warned you with my eyes. But your flesh overruled your spirit. Vicious wolves, they are all there. They prey on you. They want your money. How come he's dating you? And he's been dating you for 5 years and he has not let anybody know. Do you think? Where are your brains, my friend? What is wrong with you? They take your money and you come and report to me. Don't try it again. Don't try it. I want to be upfront with you. Don't try it. Where did you leave your brains at? What is wrong with you? He can't work. The one who's supposed to give you money is taking money from you, and you are happy and you are keeping it quiet. I have some names for you, but they are in my head. That's why I've told you that some appointments, please don't book. Do not book. I am old enough, a few years, I'll be 70, so I can say anything I want to say. They pray on you. Where's my scripture? How dare you leave it? Bring it back. And he says, also from amongst yourself in the church, men will rise up speaking perverse things. I wish I had the time to show you what it means. Car park prophets giving you words outside, drawing you, watering down the message that has been taught, drawing disciples after themselves. So external and internal, we have to protect you. Some of you, your parents are somewhere, I don't want to mention names for security reasons, they are all watching me, and they are consulting all kinds of people. They are calling you, you need to call this prophet, what is wrong with you? What are you looking for? What is wrong with you? You go to those people, their churches, apart from that so-called prophet, nobody has prospered. Now look at you. What we have done with you. And those are the places. And they will tell you, the church you go, your pastor doesn't see. What do you want to see? Please let me tell you, Pastor Kwame is speaking Hebrew now. He says, Asabo, please listen to me. Listen to me. This CCC business from your silly culture. That's CC. So after all the seeing, what have you become? They did pay your bill? And any man of God who proposes and professes to see everything is a soothsayer. There are some things that are called secret things with the Lord. He won't show you everything. He doesn't show me everything. No. What makes you think you are so big that you must see everything? And don't come and sit in front of me and say, Pastor, what do you see? I see videos. Stop it. I know, please forgive. I know I have it. I know I have the gift. But it is not press a button and it happens. That is why they are lying to you and taking your money. Charlatans, vicious wolves. I'm protecting you. And the ones who laugh loudest, you are the guiltiest. Thank you. This woman comes up. I think she was talking to mommy. This person, some of you are recruiters for those prophets. You should be ashamed of yourself. Find a better recruitment to do. Recruit people for this. And you know what the pastor was asking the guy? The lady, I need 7 shirts. And you know that he said the same things that your pastor wears. Jealous spirit. Silly man. If you are watching me, silly man. On a given Sunday, you go about and check their messages. The ones I preach here on Sunday. Don't value good things until you lose it. Protect you. Number 3, they guide you. Your man of God sometimes is giving insight. I may not have done physics. I may not have done economics. I may not have done defense studies. But there's an insight that can be given in your particular area of expertise that comes from the Spirit. Elisha gave war generals battle formations. It's possible. A man came to me the other day. This little business. Said, Papa, what do you think? I said, let's pray about it. A business that you wouldn't even think about. He invited mommy and I to come and see. I walked into his factory and I was like, whoa. You could see like a little child in a toy shop. Next time, he said, Papa, come and see again. It's expanded. And I said, you are buying a whole town. I go to Africa. He calls me. The same thing. Doesn't talk. And you want to hide. No. And the 4th thing is they bless you. When you properly relate with your man of God, when you connect to them, something happens in your life. I hope I'm helping you. Unfortunately, like I said, we've lost this. And people don't even know it. Because in our minds, what we have seen is that they are hirelings. They have no power. So there's a grand plan, especially on social media, to cause people not to relate or connect to their men of God. They take a bad example, and then they show you and make it seem like we are all like that. We are not all like that. We may be some like that, but we are not all like that. Sometimes it's familiarity. The silent killer. Especially when you have sat in church for too long. You know everything. So familiarity sets in. Remember the excitement you had the first day you walked in here and you heard me? Where is it? Now you are bored. When I'm preaching, you don't even take notes. Look at the way you're looking at me. It's our pastor. Yeah. Look at you. You don't care. I watch you. You don't take notes anymore. I watch you. Me, this thing, as I stand here, is a battle. I'm watching things. You don't even share anything from him anymore. You rather share other pastors and tell the whole world how anointed they are. Listen, don't leave the one who loves you to go and follow the one you love. So long as, I will walk this line. So long as it is your own ministry, you see the way you share? And you let us rest. When was the last time you said, as for this week, I'm taking my father's ministry and I'm putting it out there? I feel like mentioning names. What? Help you, your Exodus, you let us rest. When was the last time you posted your papa and made noise? Because it is you. Yesterday you put a little corner there, papa, because you tagged somebody. Somebody tagged you, then you tag. Don't bring yourself. I can make you a whole example today. Selfish. Yeah, let me tell you something. Those of you who say, today everybody has a ministry. Thank God for that. That I have been able to give birth to ministries. But Paul the Apostle, he had a local church in Antioch. And he would not move until the apostles and the prophets in the church lay hands and send them forth. Today, I only see your flyer before you come and tell me, Papa, go. Listen, standing on pulpits, putting your face out there, it's a battle. You don't know. This thing is not social media. It's a battle for souls. And you are speaking and you will be tested. Paul, I know. Jesus, I know. Who are you? You will be tested. Bullets that can fly. You have no idea. You are weak. It's not your gift that protects you. You have no idea that you are gifted. You are all over the place. But there are some things that are very wrong. And you don't understand. Things are fighting you. Who laid hands on you? Who inaugurated that ministry that you have? You have no respect. So everybody has a ministry. Minister this, minister, take it. You are not afraid of this thing. Familiarity. Listen, familiarity has a price. I don't want to get in there. I just want to stop. But it has a price. Get bored. You don't care about church. No excitement. Jesus the Christ went to Nazareth, his own hometown, his backyard, Mark chapter 6. He preached, they was like, wow. They all say, hey, hold it. Where did he get these things from? The Bible says that he was offended. The Son of God, the one who walked on water, the one who caused trees to die, the one who brought fish out of nothing. The Bible says that he could not do. It didn't say he will not do. He could not do. Familiarity. How is it that? Listen, when I go to place, some of you follow me. You see what happens. The truth is that whatever happens when I go out, the anointing doesn't increase. It's the same on my life. It's the receivership. So let me give you how you can connect with a man of God and I'm done. I heard somebody say, finally. No, I'm just starting. I hope I'm teaching you something. You know, these things happen once in a while, but I have to say it because it helps you. It's pastor's appreciation. I have to say it. Amen. I said amen.
Amen.
So the first thing you do is to receive him. Receive your man of God. Receive him. That is, accept him. Accept his ministry as somebody sent by God to you. Remember, he is a man of God, a man first, human. But God called him, and God, that's why I read Hebrews 5 and 1 and Hebrews 5, 1, 5 and 1 and 4. God sends them to you. He said, I will give you pastors after my own heart. So God knows who is right for you. He knows who is right for you. I may not come from where you come from. I may not speak like how you speak from where you come from. But I am sent to you. The anointing, the power, the grace, the call has no accent, has no call, has no color code, has no nationality. 1 Thessalonians 2:13. Let me do this very quickly. I'm beginning to wrap up. 1 Thessalonians. We urge you, brethren, to recognize those 1 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse number 13, please. Not that one. Let's do that first. For this reason, we also thank God with us, is because when you received the word of God, which you heard from us, you welcomed it not as the word of men, but as in truth the word of God, which effectively works in you who believe. So when you hear the word of God, stop looking for suspects. Who has been talking to pastor about me? You think I'm that little? I've been in this thing for 40 some years. You think God doesn't speak to me? You only clap when I pick up somebody else's matter. Until it is your matter. Then you are looking for suspects. No. There's somebody called the Holy Spirit. So receive it. Number two, respect him. You must respect your man of God. Show them respect. That is where the 1 Thessalonians 5, 12 and 3 happens. So you receive him, you respect him. Give me 1 Thessalonians. Are you learning?
Yes, sir.
I'll be done in a few minutes. I'm timing myself. Never mind. I'll be fine. And we urge you, brethren, sisters, recognize those who labor among you and are over you in the Lord and admonish you. Esteem them very highly in love for their work's sake and be at peace among. So you esteem them, you respect them highly for their work's sake. For their work's sake. So you show them respect. And please, let me say something. One of the ways you show respect to a person is the name. You revere the name of the person. The name, that is what drives the oil. Let me tell you, I can be anointed as anything, so anointed that I glow in the dark. But if somebody has destroyed my name to you, and you have received it, the anointing will work for many of you. That is your problem. I think this area is very guilty, so please keep clapping, keep clapping. Yeah. You listen. You listen to never do wells. You listen to losers. Because they want to draw you away from your shepherd who protects you so they can sleep with you for no reason. And I am the barrier and the resistance. So the only way we can is to go after his name. So you can be vulnerable. Respect. Do you know in Philippians 2, Jesus, he did a lot of work in the form of God. He took upon himself the form of man, came a servant, obedient unto death, blah, blah, blah. And God, after all the sacrifices, you know his reward? God has given him a name that is above every name. All the thing he did, his reward was a name. So anybody who spots your name has no regard for what you carry. And some cultures are very good at that. Name spoilers. Number three, when mommy says, it means go on. Number three, resource him. Resource your man of God. Resource it. In modern day Loganville English, find ways to give to him. Find ways to give to your man of God. Find ways. And by the way, when you want to give to him, it's not what you don't like that you go and give it to him. Find out what he likes. Other than that, don't do it. Isaac said to Esau, my son, I don't know what time I may depart. But go out there and hunt game for me. And prepare the kind of food that I like. Not what you, that I like. I like it. Such as I love. Do it. Make me savory food that I like and bring you that my soul may bless you before I die. Do you know there are two kinds of blessings? The one that comes from our lips, which is very flowery, very theological. And there's a prayer that comes from the soul. You know it. So some people bother me, Papa, pray for me. And I say, wait. Say, Papa, no. And I tell you, do you want the one from my mouth? It is very nice. I even pray in King James, thou, O God, who traveleth all the world, and thine, hey, day, day, day. Or you want the one that from my soul, that can be one sentence, and yet has set you up that nobody can reverse. I'm schooling you, my friend. After this, I won't talk about this for a very long time. And then finally, you reassure him. Reassure him. That is, your words must mean well to him. Please listen. If you don't know, let me say something to you. There's a lot of things that fight us, your men and women of God. Fight us, fight our family, fight our health, fight our everything. Last night, mommy was, I was lying down, she was listening to a man of God that I so much respect, I so much honor. I didn't know that this man was battling. If I mentioned his name, I'm sure about 90% of us would have heard of this man. He was my inspiration. The first time I heard this man speak, I was in the city of London. It was like I couldn't have enough. I had to fight to be able to get close to this man, give him an offering, let him sign his book for me. out of him, there are some great names in America today that came out of that man's doors that he opened for them. And I looked at this man, all his handsomeness, his eloquence, his power, his church, lost everything. And he weighs, is it 130 pounds? I said, Lord, this work is heavy. This cross. Please, the things that fight us are many. So those of you who love us, please say things to us that will help us. I'm telling you, if you know anything about this thing called pastoring in today's world, the statistics are not pretty. I'm telling you. Every month in America, over 1,600 pastors leave the ministry. Month. In America. Month. Think about it. Statistics about pastors say that they have lost self-esteem more than even when they began ministry. It has affected their families adversely. Pastors' kids are hurting because they were taken away by people who dumped them later. You know how sometimes our kids feel when you guys come around us? One time, one of my kids asked me, where are they? She mentioned names. Where are they? She did. Very blunt with me. I couldn't answer. Where are they? So when they come, we get jittery because we know the outcome. They'll be happy until you offend them. They know our loneliness in the midst of thousands of people. They know. We fight the ridicule of society. They ridicule us. Jesus is on the cross. Done nothing wrong. Two malefactors. The one begins to ridicule him. Even in your pain, you are going to die. You are still ridiculing him. Human nature. But the other one rebuked him. So please, some of you need to fight for us. We face roadblocks of Satan. Don't forget that. So pastors, when you get opportunity to speak, when I'm not here, speak for Papa and stop your own personal preachings. That only matters to you. Are you going to clap or something before I do something to you? You've been waiting for me to say this. You see, a man who carries an anointing, there's boldness. Ministry is sense, strategy. It's not just preaching. My personal family. Come on. It's a plan. Because we are taking people somewhere, not driving people to my own thing. We go through stress. Stress from unreasonable expectations. Hear me, your pastor is not God, in case you don't know. Don't force me to give you what even God hasn't promised you. We get tired. In fact, all the time we are tired. The world is led by tired leaders. If you don't know, we are tired. Moses, this man of God, at the battle of Amalek, Exodus 17, he got tired. The strategy was lift up your hands until Amalek is defeated. Joshua is there doing the hands-on cutting, but somebody is determining the battle. So if I don't show up at your prayer meeting, if I don't show up at your meetings, it doesn't mean I'm asleep. What I'm doing, you can't do. Moses got tired, and so long as he was tired and his hands were coming down, all nations was losing the battle. Aaron and Hur saw it. They didn't go and take the rod from Moses. No, that would be out of order. People are giving designations. You can't take it and do it. So they gave him immediate help. They let him sit down. And then they kept his hands up. Hear me. Aaron stands for the priesthood. What is their thing? Intercession. Aaron from the tribe of Judah. What is it? Praise. So intercession, pray for him and speak good to him. That is how the battle is won. So Moses is referred to as a man of God. Number two, he's blessing. And then finally, he's blessing the people of God. This is it. Then I'm done. I'm going to not go to finish this. I think Saturday is a glory hour. And I'll be continuing in that. Blessing you. It's going to be a blessing service. But he says that, note this. Deuteronomy 33, verse 1. He says, now this is the blessing. Somebody say the blessing. The blessing. Say it. The blessing. This, when we say this is there, it means there's a tangibility about the blessing that you see. Please, the blessing that comes to you from your man of God, whatever, has a tangibility, has evidence and results. Every true man of God, every true one, they carry something that is unusual, and it is for your profit. Your profit is for your profit. They carry presence, they carry power, much as we try to hide it, because our humility. Galatians chapter 2, verse number 9, I think. Galatians 2 and 9, I think. It says that they perceived the grace that was given to Paul, or Paul also. And when James, Peter, John, who seemed to be, they perceived the grace that has, you can see grace has been given to somebody. You can see it. And most, the Bible says that this is the blessing that is. And today, I want to finish with only one. Please give me verse number 6 of Deuteronomy 33, then I'm done. I want to give you that. I'm going to speak it over your head. The first thing that Moses said, he said, let Reuben live and not die. Let not his men be few. That is what I'm going to declare over you. Because you know something? Moses was reversing some order. Because when you connect this to Genesis 49, before Jacob died, he called his 12 sons. Reuben was the firstborn. You are my might. You are my dignity, excellence of strength. But he said, because of something you did, and I didn't say anything. Because of something you did, and Papa didn't say anything, I pretended I haven't seen. The day of reckoning, this is the day that you should have shown, and your breakthrough should have come. But listen to what Father said over his son. Unstable as water, you shall not excel. You know instability of water? Water takes the form and the shape of anything that is poured in. So life puts you in circumstances and makes you like the circumstance. The tribe of Reuben, they could never properly cross into the promised land. They stayed at the other side of Jordan. Instability. They were the first tribe to be totally obliterated when Israel was carried into captivity. Never found them again because somebody spoke. And even that, what if Moses had not been? What, you look at the statistic of Israel, they go to war. And if any people would die, rarely, those from Reuben. Maybe I don't know what may have been spoken over your head, but I want to reverse it over you. Amen. Woman evangelist, he said, let Reuben live. And could it be that there are people, you are alive, but you are dead? You know when the prodigal son was leaving home, Papa didn't say anything. But when he came back and the brother was protesting, what did he say to the brother? He said, this, your brother was dead. So when he was leaving, Papa knew he was dead, but Papa didn't say anything. What is it in the head of your Papa that he knows about what he hasn't said? I pray for you. On Saturday, I'll be doing proper ministry. Today, I want to quit. But anything that is a reversal of your fortunes, that is a limiting curse over your life, I command it to be reversed. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Amen. Hear me. Reuben. Hear me, Reuben. Reuben, female Reuben. Male Reubens. You can have master's degree and yet you master nothing. You are forced to be married and you are not happy. You have a good job, but you never have anything staying to show. All you put out on social media is a lie. But I'm speaking over your head today in the name of the Lord. That let everything that has been contrary to your fortunes, let it be reversed today. Amen. Anything in your bloodline as a result of what your father did, or your mother did, and what they said, and everything that has put a limitation on your head, I stand as your man of God in the name of the Lord, and I command it to be reversed in the name of the Lord Jesus. Every invisible line that has been set in your life, may it be broken in the name of the Lord Jesus. Any up and downs in your life, I command them to be obliterated in the name of the Lord Jesus. I command the valleys to be exalted. I command your mountains to come down, and I command your rough roads to be made straight. I speak into your life in the name of the Lord Jesus, that live and not die. Let not your fortunes be few in the name of the Lord Jesus. From today, walk in unexplainable blessing. I decree a blessing over you. I stayed up all week, prayed, and I, Lord, put your blessing on my tongue to speak over the heads of these ones, just like your servant said to his son, that I have blessed and I cannot reverse. So I bless you that cannot be reversed. I bless you with happiness. I bless you with breakthroughs. I bless you with forward march. I bless you with elevation. I bless you with exaltation. I bless you with success. I bless you with goodness. I bless you with health. I bless you with health. I bless you with peace. I bless you with success. Let your smell be like a field that the Most High God has blessed. May God Almighty give you the dew of heaven, plenty of corn and wine. Let not your head lack oil. Let not your head lack oil. I pray that your bank account will never laugh at you. I pray in the name of the Lord Jesus that doors be open, doors be open, doors be open. And just like he said, you will not die but live. You will not be taken before your time. Death will not be successful with an assignment against you in the name of the Lord Jesus. May your children never bring you pain. May your children never cause you to shed tears in the name of the Lord Jesus. I pray that the joy of the Lord shall wear you like a coat in the name of the Lord Jesus. I am speaking a blessing over you. Be blessed in your going out. Be blessed in your coming in. Be blessed in your sitting. Be blessed in your rising. Be blessed in your business. Be blessed in your relationship. Be blessed in your dating. Be blessed in your marriage. Be blessed in your ministry. Be blessed in your job. Be blessed in your career. Be blessed in your education. Be blessed in every area of your life. Let it be said wherever you go that the woman that is blessed has come this way. The man that is blessed has come this way. May all that are sitting waiting for you to be destroyed, may they wait indefinitely in the name of the Lord Jesus. And the group of people that have sat to determine about you, let their words be destroyed. Let their petitions be disregarded before the throne of God in the name of the Lord Jesus. We cut their communication lines. We blind the monitoring spirits against you in the name of the Lord. Rise as the champion in your family. Rise as the first one in your family. Do things that your father couldn't do. Do things that your mother couldn't do. Do things with least effort in the name of the Lord Jesus. I pray for you by the authority invested in me as a servant of God by reason of my sacrifices. I make a demand over my pain. I make a demand over my sacrifice, the blood that I've shed. And Father, I say that if there's only one blessing left, give it to somebody in this church. Give it to somebody watching me today. In the name of the Lord Jesus, I pray that your smell shall change. In the name of the Lord, be attracted, be attractive, be attractive, be attractive. Mataba satataeka. I am speaking over somebody's life. I am changing words that have been spoken over your life. You are here and things have been said that have limited you. Today I negate their effect in the midst of all the things that have been said. May God lift you up. May God promote you. May God show people that he is your God and they are not your God. God calls, God calls. God caused laughter to be heard in your tabernacle. God caused laughter to be heard in your tabernacle. May the enemy never blindside you. May the enemy never blindside you. In the name of the Lord, may doors be open. 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 I am blessing you. I am blessing you. He said that this is the blessing that the man of God blessed. And I said, this is the blessing. I am blessing you. I am blessing your children. I am blessing your grandchildren. I'm blessing your great-grandchildren. In the name of the Lord, let that pain be gone. Let that pain be gone. Let that hurt be gone. Rise as a new man. Rise as a new woman. I am blessing you today. The voice of the Lord speaks. It's the same voice that thunders over the water. The voice that splits the cedars of Lebanon. Yeah, I feel it. I feel it. I feel the hand. I feel the hand. I feel the hand. I feel the hand. It is like some fire. Let that fire come upon your head today. Let that fire come upon your head today. I am reversing satanic predictions. I am reversing satanic predictions in the name of the Lord Jesus. Let God arise. 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 Let not your men be few. Live, my daughter. Live, my son. Live, my granddaughter. Live, my grandson. Live, 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 live. I am speaking life into every area of your life. Life to your marriage. Life to your business. Life to your career. Life to your vision. Life, 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 life. No more disrespect. No more disrespect. No more cycles of defeat. I break them. I break the cycles of defeat in the name of the Lord. Live and not die. Let no blessing die in your hands. Let no breakthrough die in your hands. From today, let doors be open. God give you the eyes to discern the doors. Those that are doors. And may God give you the wisdom to outwit trap doors, so they don't take you down. So I have declared over you, and so it will remain. If you agree with me, say amen. And put your hands together. Bless the Lord. Keep kneeling now. Keep kneeling. No, the keep kneeling that was just for this woman. But if you still want to kneel, that's fine. So for this one. Because I'm changing something. Those arrows from Malawi. Nataheka. In the name of the Lord. The things that were spoken over you from age 12. They will not die. Daughter, today I am blessing you. Blessing that will set you free. The pain, the hurts, receive your healing, my daughter. You have carried yourself with dignity. But God knows. Elroy knows. And when he knows and he hears, he comes. And when he comes, oh, look at that. Father, let the fire burn upon this one. There's a ministry coming out of you. A ministry of healing. Take this, daughter, take this. Ministry of healing. To many, your voice will heal. You will sing and cancers will disappear. You will sing and things will happen. The prophetic is upon you. I'm opening the well of the prophetic. Prophetic is upon you. In the name of the Lord Jesus, I open the floodgates and the wells of the prophetic. From this house, daughter, I shoot you forth into the world. I send you into the world. From this house, your oil will never run dry. Today is your deliverance, daughter. Today is your freedom. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I apologize. I have to stop this. I have to stop it. But Saturday, from praise and worship, I'll pick up the microphone. And we'll see what will happen. And what will happen will happen. Amen. Now, please sit. Let me talk to you for 2 minutes. Have you been blessed today? This is your house. Yeah, I didn't ask you to clap. So if you are clapping, clap well before I do something to you. You know, was it... During the resurrection Sunday morning, I made an announcement here that we've paid for our facilities, everything, debt-free. Then I shared with you the legacy project. Now, listen to me. This was paid a little while before I was released to make the announcement. I have leaders around me. I consult. I'm not a bank of wisdom. And one of the things that people battled with, leaders around me, counsel, that kind of thing, was, you know your people. And once you say everything is paid, people won't give again. I said, no, I trust my people. And you know, you made my leaders, their words come true to hunt me. I normally don't do this, but I called for our finance things and said, I want to see. My God. Like from the day I made the announcement, most giving in the church came to a screeching halt. And the question is, why? In such a good church, a good atmosphere, why? You realize I said I was going to do this legacy center, not for me, for your children. Parents, for your children. Nope. It's like, I don't even want to tell you what people have given. It almost borders on the ridiculous. Why are we like that? Let me tell you something. Please, again, forgive me if I've said something about Prince. I can't say anything about anybody. There are very few top-notch positions in this church that I don't pay people to do. I hardly have volunteers in this church. Today, I'll say it, and I'll be free. I know you will not be offended, but a lot of church things here, I pay almost everything. I don't want to mention things. I pay. For some of the most mundane things in this house, people collect money from me. Who say that they are my sons and daughters? That out of this ministry, God has blessed, but they don't see. One time I had to ask somebody, this $200, what would it do for you? What will it do for you? With all your age and your height and what God has done for you, what will it do? That is why I've told you. The finance guys are standing watching me. I think they are there. Since 2006, June, me, never taking a pay raise in this house. Because I demonstrate my work and I get blessed, not from this house, but outside. You should have seen my phone this morning. I'm saying all this to say that this is your house. So if you come in one day and there are no air conditionings, no light, no nothing, it means we are bankrupt. You know, we don't put pressure. You should go to some churches and see the way they twist them. That is why these people twist you, because they know how you are. I don't want to scare you to give. I don't believe in fear motivation. I believe in faith motivation. I hope by now you believe us enough that I've been here for all these years. I'm saying all this that it is time for tithe and offerings. I'm coming back to second service, Gen X. The average giving for all the hundreds of young guys. Gen X from what age to what age? 18 to 35. Or? 14 to 35 year olds. You know their tithe, their collective offering every Sunday average $200. $200. You know how much we pay them? $200. A whole church. On a Sunday, average, $200. I lost my mother tongue. $200. You think I should be rolling out the red carpet? No. This is not right. This is not right. This is not right. It's our time for tithe and offering. Let's do it. Let me dedicate my 6 babies and I'm out of here. 7. Somebody else. 7. We'll have fun here. I'll be questioning people. Matilda, why are you laughing like that? Nothing. Okay, nothing. Who says I haven't seen that you have changed? Record. Give us the giving record online, everyone. Let's give. Giving platforms. Let's do that.
Dependable, dependable.
my way, you are still kind. You are intentional, intentional kind. Everything is working out for my good.
Please bring up, bring them. If you are done, please come put them there. Or if it's digital, you can touch the altar. Going to dedicate 7 babies. No, for a lot of them, they were waiting to know that I'm here. I know the trick. So no problem. Let me tell you something. This thing was told by Bishop T.D. Jakes. So for me, there's nothing wrong with this. Hurricane Katrina, remember that? It hit Louisiana very bad. And thousands of people found themselves in the dome. And it was a very terrible thing. And I saw one of the great blemishes in the American social life. And a lot of celebrities and people went there to encourage the brothers and sisters who were in the dome. Very bad thing. Oprah Winfrey was there. Some of these people, you know, they were all there. Bishop T.D. Jakes, he went there, spoke powerfully to motivate them. And Bishop Jakes said that as he turned to leave, an 80-something-year-old, spry little woman walked up to him and said, "Bishop Jakes, thank you so much for coming. Your words were very powerful, they were very eloquent, they were very good. But if I could only hear the voice of my pastor, I know that everything is going to be okay." So there may be many voices, but the voice of your pastor. So I know. I know. My only thing I'm begging all of you is when you have finished, don't disappear until the next dedication. Make sure you are a tither. For some, I'm doing it out of love. You can see that this man is on a warpath. But our culture has to change. There's something for nothing. Using papa has to change. I know for some of you would have waited for me if I came back to 2025. So it's fine. Marvelous and Alfred, please bring Angel. Abigail and Richard, please bring Junior Richard. No, don't look at them. Just turn around. This one has a testimony. Huh. Very powerful. I can't share the testimony. No, I won't share. I've spoken too much. So Richard and Abigail here. Yes, come up. Anna and Evans, Saki, please. Anna and Evans, please. Come up, Anna. Come up, Evans. Pastors, can you please arrange them for me nicely? Abigail and Jonas. Abby, this way. Yes, Abby and Kwabna, please stand here. There are two Abigails, actually. There's an Abigail and Jonas. Where is Abigail and Jonas? They are somewhere. Okay. Oh, yeah. Abby is here. Jonas, come. Can we have Naomi and Francis? Naomi and Francis, come this way. Francis, I've asked you, where is Naomi for about 1,000 years? You never told me that she was in the factory. You're in trouble. Please, this way. Come this way. And who have we got again? Henry and Emanuela. Where's Henry and Emanuela? Come on, Henry. Where's Manny, baby? Come up. Yeah, Henry and Emanuela are doing two. So good to see all of you. Abby, you're looking so good. Abna, well done. Don't give me a straight face. Wow, this is beautiful. This is beautiful. You all waited for me and I'm here. We have prayed for these children before we showed up here. Naomi, did he always tell you, I ask of you? He never told me that you were in the factory of production. But congratulations to everybody. So everybody is here. I think everybody is here. Have we got everybody? Did we get everybody? Okay. Please listen, all the parents, loved ones, grandparents, friends, family. We want to welcome all of you this morning to the house of the Lord. You brought your babies to be dedicated to the Lord. Number one is a sign of gratitude to God. Because the Bible says that children are inherited of the Lord, and the fruit of the womb is his reward. So we are thankful, we are grateful that God did this for you. You went into labor, you came back, you came with your blessing, and we are grateful. You are standing in this house today, surrounded by friends and family, and also this house, your community, saying to the Lord that we implore your help to help the parents parent them well and help these children grow up well. The world that these children have entered into is not a pleasant place. It's a tight place. It's not going to get better in the world, but we ask the protection of the Lord over these children. The Bible says that Whatever we hand into the hands of the Lord, His capable hands keep the children. So we are going to pray for every single one of these children. We are going to dedicate them. We are going to bless them. There have been times that parents have come to me with issues with their children, and I've told them, go back and watch the video of the things that we spoke over the children. Words are irrevocable. Words go through time and land in eternity. So we're going to do, who is here? Henry and Emanuela. Could you step forward, please? All right. Who is Victoria Inez? The little one? Okay. Then Henny Johanna. Where do you get those names from? Money. This is Victoria. Eh? Yeah, I want the lighter one first. She's even heavy. I made a bad mistake. Victoria, Inez, I hold you in my hands in the name of the Lord, employing all the mercies and the graces of God. And I dedicate you into the hands of God Almighty. Victoria, today, in the presence of God Almighty and this holy congregation, I speak over you and I say that you are the personification of greatness and virtue walking in human flesh on earth. Every day of your life, excel. Every day of your life, shine. Every day of your life, surprise people with what God has packaged on the inside of you. Your eloquence, your grace, the victories that you will bring to your family shall be documented. Victoria Innes, I say, at school amongst the best, be the best. Never will you struggle with academics. Never will you struggle with which way to go. And the only one that shall surpass you in greatness shall be God alone. Today, I make this irrevocable declaration over your head that you are blessed. All the days of your life until you stand before the Lord in a ripe old age, you walk in inexplicable blessings. So I have declared over you, so it remains. In Jesus' name, amen. Henny Johanna Asare Blankson. I dedicate you into the capable hands of the Most High God. An honor and a pleasure to hold greatness in my hands. Just as John the Baptist was filled with the Spirit from a young age, so be filled with the Spirit of God. Wisdom, insight, understanding, knowledge, and grace. You'll be academically astute, be intellectually amazing. You will solve problems that are too complex for young ones to do. Your wisdom will go beyond your years. Amongst the best, you will be the best. You will bring joy and laughter into the Blankson home. I pray over you, Johanna, today, and I decree that the only one that surpasses you in greatness shall be God alone. I pray that today let heavens look over you with mercies and graces. Do things in your lifetime that will be written about for many years. Sickness, disease, infirmity, calamity will never locate you. You will be a sign. You will be a wonder. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, I dedicate you to the capable hands of the Lord. Amen. Genesis, Eden, Abna, Sika, Arthur. You are not an ordinary baby. You are not a normal one who came in just to make up the numbers. You are going to be an extraordinary human being on this earth. You will begin things in your family that have never been done before. You will put aside traditions that didn't help and establish new traditions that will help. When bloodlines have been traced, they will come back to you that you were the one that started this in the family and has been a blessing.
Amen.
Genesis, Eden. At school, amongst the best, you will be the best. Your wisdom, your insight, your intellect will go beyond natural years and abilities. You will be a sign and you will be a wonder. The only one that shall surpass you in greatness shall be God alone. You will accomplish what parents couldn't accomplish. You will cross lines your forebears couldn't cross. Whatever brings people down will never locate you. Whatever causes tears will never knock on your door successfully. Genesis, you will be rich. Rich in money. Rich in resources. Rich in everything that people will see and give glory to God. The name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, I dedicate to you. Amen. Okay, I think we can do that.
On behalf of All Nations Church, we present this baby dedication certificate to you, signifying that on this day you dedicated Genesis Eden into the capable hands of the Lord. Amen.
So you may be seated.
Let me give
you. Can create more space. So yes. Man, you and your tribe. Are we done? Okay. Naomi and Francis, please bring. Is it Nyla? You heard your name? Nyla Kojo. The portals of heaven are open over you today. As you've been brought into the house of the Lord to be dedicated to the hands of the one who gave you permission to come to this earth. You did not get here by accident. You came by the predetermined counsel of the Most High God. The God before whom I serve and stand today look over you with eyes of grace, eyes of goodness. You will exude the virtues of divinity, wisdom, counsel, insight, ability, productivity, and innovation shall be that which you bring forth. You will be a source of laughter in the home of your parents. At school, amongst the best, you will be the best. You will excel beyond measure. Today, I decree that the only one that surpasses you in greatness shall be God alone.
Amen.
Sickness, disease, infirmity, calamity, tragedy will never locate you. The eyes of the wicked one will not set on you. I decree over you, Nyla, that today, God sets permanent angels to watch and guide you because of what you carry.
Amen.
Like Joseph with a coat of many colors, everywhere you go, you'll be noticed. The eyes of jealousy will never derail that which God wants to do with you. So in the name of God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, I dedicate you. Amen. Abby. Richard Kwabena Yeboah Jr. You have entered this world with your own agenda. Not to tone the line of ordinariness. Not to become normal like anybody else. You will be noticed that there's something different about this one. Because you will speak and your speech does not correspond to your age. You will think you legislate, then people will say, where did you get these things from? But from this tender age, you are filled with wisdom, knowledge, intelligence, understanding that comes from divinity alone. You came into this world to light up our world. You came into this world to make a difference. You're a difference maker, I hear that. Richard, today I hold you in my hands as I stand before God Almighty, before myself. I stand. And I make a declaration over you that all your life in academics, amongst the best, you'll be the best. You will set new benchmarks that will be referred to. You'll be a sign for many that come after you. Because of you, your father and your mother will forever be grateful to God that they were the instruments of you coming into this world. Where there's suffering, bring relief. Where there's pain, bring healing. Where there's lack, bring abundance. Where there's darkness, light up the world. Richard, the only one that surpasses you in greatness shall be God alone. Sickness, disease, infirmity, calamity will never locate you. You will shine. You will shine. You will shine all the days of your life. So in the name of God, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, I dedicate you. Amen. Marvelous. Where is Marvelous? Angel, Meshach, Alfred Williams. Your story is a miracle already. Truthfully, by human standards, you should not have been here, but you are here. Just as you surprised detractors, all the days of your life, you will be a surprise. Many will marvel and ask that how could it be so? Because you are loaded with a lot that many men can be loaded for many lifetimes. I hold you in my hands today as a privilege. And today I make a declaration over your head never to be reversed or revoked. That amongst the best, you will be the best academically. You will be sought out because of your wisdom and insight. You will do amazing things. Marvelous, today I make a declaration that the only one that shall be greater than you here on earth shall be God alone. Everywhere you go, everything you touch shall be blessed. Sickness, disease, infirmity, calamity will never locate you. You'll be an awesome child to become an awesome adult. You will bring goodness to this side of heaven called earth. Today, I make a declaration as I dedicate you into the hands of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, that indeed you are a child of promise. Live that promise today in the name of the Lord Jesus. Amen. Smiling. Alana Adoma Chisom Chidi. Ordinariness, never your portion. This world has waited for you to your arrival. I hold you in my hands today. And the privilege is mine to dig into the oil to dedicate you to God who gave you permission to come here. Alana, today I speak over your head and I say that in this competitive world, you will be the competition. Because you will be the benchmark from which competitors look up to. But what is upon you will make you unassailable. Elena, today, academically, amongst the best, you will be the best. From this tender age, the manifestations of God's grace shall be plenty upon you. Wherever you go, let it be said that a wonder has come this way. I speak over you and I say, young one, that because of you, laughter, brightness, shining will never depart from the tabernacles of your parents. You will be a mighty extension of the goodness that rests upon the tabernacle of your parents. You go out, you bring good news. You go out, you bring joy. You go out, you bring virtue. You go out, you bring everything that parents have looked out for. Never will you disappoint the hearts of your parents. I speak over you, Alana. And I say that the only one that shall be greater than you shall be God alone. You will stand out. You will shine. Sickness, disease, infirmity, and calamity will never come near you. You will outwit the footprints of your enemy all the days of your life. So today, I hold you in my hands before God Almighty. And I dedicate you into His capable hands. As we have declared over you, it remains forever. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Anybody has a baby?
Dr. Fran and Pastor Mary of Ofosu-Appiah, we want to thank you for worshiping with us today, and we hope to see you again. Please, all married couples, head out to the fellowship hall for an important update right after service. We promise you it will be short, but informative. Thank you. Gen Next News. Gen Next Arise, our high schoolers will be having a meet and greet immediately after the first service. The event will take place in the youth building and will feature donuts. Mwah, yummy. We would like to invite all high school students to come join us for a fun and casual gathering. This will be a great opportunity for the students to meet and get to know one another, as well as to learn more about Gen Next Arise and what they have planned for the upcoming year. Very interesting. On Tuesday, 31st of October at 11:30 p.m., please join us on the prayer line as we cross over into November. Come, let us pray as we approach the end of the year. Prayer is the key. This Wednesday, Bible study of 1st of November will be in person right here at Kharis House at 7 p.m. prompt with Papa, since it will be the first Wednesday of November. Please come, let us learn together. The family of late Mr. Philip Kwasi Alewobu, father of our brother Eden Marty and father-in-law to Rachel Marty, are immensely grateful to all those who came out yesterday to support them for the celebration of life service. Please remember to keep them in your prayers always. Thank you. The Community Engagement and Outreach Department is inviting all those interested to go out on evangelism, prayer, and praise in the park at Briscoe Park on Saturday, November 18th, 2023 at 10 a.m. If you're interested in going out on evangelism with us, please contact Brother Kwabena Adade on 615-423-3069 for more information. Remember to stop by the Manor Bookstore for some good books penned by our own Dr. Frank Ofosu-Appiah and other authors. Also, we have the ISI 2023 material and some gifts on the shelves. Remember to stay connected and listen to inspiring messages on all our social media handles at All Nations Kharis House. And every Tuesday at 6 p.m., join the Ambassador of Hope on his YouTube and Facebook handles as he shares some wisdom nuggets to encourage you. Don't miss it. October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and you're encouraged to do the needful to save the Tartars. This week, know that appreciation is a wonderful thing. It makes what is excellent in others belong to you as well. This has been me for ANC News. What's my name? The Minister of Enjoyment? Evangelist Phoebe. What's my name? Evangelist Phoebe. I'll see you next week.
Please forgive us. I know we've overrun the time. It's not all the time, but please forgive us. Before I say this and I step out of your way, if last Sunday you took one of my drinks that you helped the women, the drinks you took, and you made a pledge here, and you haven't redeemed it, and you have already drunk the thing. You have already drunk the thing. That says the Lord. Oh, please, if you haven't redeemed your vow, please do that. I think, especially the men and all the women who did that, please do that. Auntie Agi walked out. Auntie Agi, you are 80-something. Eh? By the way, where is Uncle Mark? Uncle Mark, today is your birthday. Come. This one is family matter. Let me do it. Forget about the time. Let me do this. If you know Uncle Mark's story, Uncle Mark should not have been here. But Uncle Mark is here. Uncle Mark is here. This is God's grace. And as a church today, we want to say happy birthday to you. I pray that this God who kept you will keep keeping you. Health. You have been a wonder. You have been a showpiece. You have been something that we look up to, and we know that the Most High God rules in the affairs of men. As a family, we bless you on this day. We ask that continued health will be yours. That God Almighty will increase you all the days of your life. May you not only just hear the voice of your grandchildren, but your great-grandchildren. God prosper you. As you grow older by the year, may your peace increase. May your wealth increase. May your health increase. Nothing good must ever decrease in your life. God himself be your God. Be your guide. Be your God all the days of your life. In Jesus' name, amen. Uncle Mark, happy birthday. I forgot. He says there's a, Auntie Pat says there's a little party next year. Next year will be the heavy duty one, eh? But can we do like a pre-next year birthday? Thank you. You know, today, you very interesting. They do like even baby gender pre-showing of gender. Auntie Agi is 83 years old. 83 years old. 83 years old. And she just walked up to me and said, Papa, let me say something. When an 83-year-old says, let me say something, I have enough sense. Give me a microphone. It's not going to be long, is it? Okay.
My words didn't ask.
Your words are even finished. Let them remain finished. I'll sit here.
Hallelujah. If I'm here this morning, I want just to say thank you to God for what he has done for my family. And again, I say thank you to my bishop. He has helped us a lot. My Mary, you've done a lot. When I come to you, I just cry. And you will be giving me a word of encouragement. Mama, thank you. Thank you so much. And again, to Pastor Kwame, I salute you, Father. You have done a lot going up and down because of my granddaughter. Pastor, thank you so much. And the same go to our mommy, Mrs. Frimpong. You are also one of those who helped, because if you did not give Pastor, agree with Pastor, you won't allow him to come going up and down the errands he was doing if you didn't agree and give her the way. I don't know what to say. I say thank you so much. You have done a lot for us. And to Pastor Sam. Pastor Sam, thank you. Thank you, Mrs. Sam. You did a lot. All of you helped this situation that we went in. And by the grace of God, now we are standing here. I say thank you, Father. Thank you. And I haven't finished.
I thought you said the words are finished. I think you want to go home.
Okay. To my colleagues, intercessors, prayer warriors, I don't know what to say. I just say thank you. God bless you all for what you have done for us.
Thank you.
Thank you. And I whispered something to God that I will do. Pastor, take me. I said,
come for your mom. You won't understand. The battles. Pastor Kwame, thank you. Thank you. Sorry? Yeah, you have to cry. I feel like crying too. Church, this thing that we are involved in, that's why I say you pray for us. You have no idea. Please stand. Please stand. Listen, I have blessed you today. On Wednesday, I'll stand here and do First Wednesday. On Saturday, to be a blessing prayer morning. Amen. Amen. Now, please, everybody, turn around. Turn around. Face the back. Those two places are doors. Please go home. We are done. Yes, we are done.
Pause to say we appreciate you to a man who exudes grace, compassion, wisdom, and selflessness, and also to a woman whose humility, gracefulness, virtuosity, and a genuine heart that gives freely with no strings attached. Some call him bishop, pastor, or daddy because he plays these roles in their lives. He is Dr. Frank Ofosu-Appiah, our senior pastor, the ambassador of hope. No matter the hour, whatever the need, you go the extra mile. Always ready to share a comfortable talk, encouragement, and smile that can be changed to a heart stir when it is warranted. We're grateful that you are here with us to teach us from His Word. Your teachings are full of wisdom and gives us a pathway, not only in our faith walk, but life as it is, letting us know wisdom from unexpected places and to dig deep. We know a lizard in Georgia will not become an alligator in Florida. Reverend Mary Ofosu-Appiah, Mommy, thank you for the grace you portray. Thank you for your genuineness, your warm embrace and smile. Thank you for being patient and listening to us even when facing your own trials. Thank you for sharing your experiences with the congregation and accepting an unwavering dedication to the work of the ministry. Also, for your simple but effective water-in-mouth prescription in times of intense fellowship. For your continued attitude of uplifting us and being the straight shooter that you are, we will not have it any other way. Today, we say thank you to both of you for the vision, for your exemplary leadership, and for releasing potential in us by connecting us to God. May our appreciation not only be in October. We truly appreciate you both, and may you be blessed.
For more information, please visit our website at allnationsusa.com or simply call the church office at 770-923-8383. Subscribe to our YouTube page. Like us on Facebook. And follow us on Twitter. Stay blessed.